Well, the question of the day from consumer reporter Randy Ripplinger is, how would you like to buy merchandise at half the price you pay now? Well, I hate to be a skeptic, Randy, but my question has to be, how much is it going to cost me to save all that money?
You're not going to tell me that sounds too good to be true, are you?
It certainly does.
Well, how about around $800?
That's a lot.
Is that a little too much to join a club that would give you some substantial savings on the stuff you buy?
Tell me more.
Yeah, I'd probably want to see the proof up front, of course. And that's what this story is all about, buying clubs, trying to lure you in a number of ways if their good reputation doesn't do it. They might offer you a free gift for listening to their sales pitch. The prize, almost inevitably, is a one-piece telephone. We obtained one of the phones, and it works. The sound is muffled, but it works. So, if you decide to look at the club itself, consider the experiences of some of the former members. Some of them are happy with the service.
The biggest savings on the high-end, furniture and stuff like that, and jewelry, you know, things like that, but there's still a savings on small items, too.
Jenny Higgins drops a fair amount of cash at Trend House. She bought a fur coat, lots of jewelry, she says, and even bought $1,800 worth of carpeting there. In fact, the Attorney General's office says that's the way to get your money's worth out of a buying club.
If you were to buy some high-ticket items, maybe you might do all right. The discounts usually are not there, and that only if you buy an amazing amount of merchandise.
And that's what Cindy Hirsch found. She became a member after paying the $699 membership fee and signing a contract promising to pay off the membership fee in 18 payments at 31% annual interest rate. And when she considered what the items were she wanted to buy, she wondered who was saving the money.
There's a lot of retail stores that, if you shop around, you're going to find the same product, if not better merchandise, for the same price, if not cheaper. When it came to the time we wanted out after the contract was signed, they told us you can't get out of it.
Other complaints to the Attorney General's office say they found cheaper prices elsewhere, too. Trend House refuses to discuss such complaints publicly, but with the help of an attorney, the Higgins got their money back. But Penny Poshman hasn't been so lucky with another buying club called Unimart. In recent years, the Attorney General's office has received a number of complaints against Unimart. Many of them deal with the sales pitch.
Like I'd just been in a steam bath. Very intense pressure. It was a one-time only offer. If you don't sign up for it now, it'll never be offered again. And I bought it hook, line, and sucker, signed up for it.
Here, the price is higher, $800 to buy a membership. Like Trend House, there is the $40 annual fee on top of that. Potential members are shown a list of manufacturers whose goods are here, but they aren't allowed to browse the merchandise itself. And the firm refuses to give Penny or anyone else a price catalog to use for comparison. It was only after she signed the dotted line that she found better buys elsewhere.
And if you just do some comparison shopping when other merchandise is on sale at retailers, you can find the same discounts or better.
She also learned upon reading all the contracts that the merchandise must be paid for when it is ordered, and orders sometimes take weeks to arrive. And if you are buying lower-priced items, the Unimart money-saving guarantee is excluded. Again, Unimart officials refuse to discuss their prices or any of the consumer complaints publicly. The Attorney General's office is investigating the firm, though no official actions have been filed yet. In the meantime, the state suggests that you should be careful when buying the buying clubs.
What I would ask if I was a consumer is say, hey, let me see your catalog. Let me take it and make some comparisons of my own. If they won't let you do that, you shouldn't buy the membership.
And that really is some good advice. You ought to always find out what you're buying before you pay for it.
But a lot of them don't offer catalogs. That's what you're saying.
None of them we found would.
Makes it tough. Thanks, Randy.
Yep.